MRN Crew Call on MRN.com is presented by MoneyLion, the world's most powerful financial membership. MoneyLion, here we roar. And also brought to you by Hercules Tires. Ride on our strength.
Oh, and welcome. Good morning on this hump day. I am Rocko Williams, and this is MRN Crew Call presented by MoneyLion. Thank you for joining us today on this beautiful Wednesday. My studio is being taken over. I'm being invaded by these invaders from Welcome.
Whoa!
let's take a moment of time to introduce yourself, starting down the line. Who do we have on my end?
I'm Ray Wright. I'm the pit crew coach at RCR.
Paul Swan, tire carrier for the number 3 Chevrolet.
Darrell Edwards, Jack, man, for the number 3 Chevrolet.
There you have it. Here we are on MRN Crew Call presented by MoneyLion. We have three superb ballers, the best to ever do it, the best out there. There's nobody better than these guys. I mean, they're the greatest pit crew members and coaches out there in NASCAR right now in my studio. Thank you guys for joining me today on this Wednesday.
Appreciate you having us, man. It's good to finally get out here.
I know, man. We've been trying. Paul and y'all, you've been on the show last season. You had to call in, but it's so great to have y'all in studio. Mm-hmm. Just real quick, I just want to talk about, we just got back from Kansas. Mm-hmm. How was Kansas in a nutshell? All of y'all can take your turns and answer this. In a nutshell, how was Kansas?
Well, from a pit crew standpoint, mm-hmm. right, from pit stops, you know, we had solid pit stops. We did a lot of adjustments in Kansas, you know, from the pit crew perspective, right? We were adjusting on the cars, and that takes a lot. You know, when you're doing, we did a lot of multi-round adjustments with our crews. So when you got multi-round adjustments, the way the NASCAR rules are set up, Darrell, the Jackman, he's got to hang out on the right side a little bit longer.
Sorry,
right?
Darrell.
You know, so
can't have that tire getting away.
Yeah, nope. So we got to watch that tire. And but over, you know, boys did a good job. We were solid and did all the adjustments. Got the car where the, you know, where they're hoping it was going to go.
That's cool. I think for me, being a carrier, you know, a lot of the adjustments fall on me, you know, mm-hmm. some of them fall on him, but those right side adjustments and tape and all that stuff, it, mm-hmm. it can make it challenging during the stop, and especially when it's multi-round adjustments. But, I mean, you know, whatever the crew chief says, you know, we take it on our shoulders, and, you know, we just go out there with the same attitude that we're going to bust off a great stop, and, you know, we take what we can get, and when the dust settles, you know, mm-hmm. we're feeling pretty good about it.
Yep. So like he said, with the 5-man stops and stuff like that, a lot of things have changed. They're really looking now for the penalties and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. So as a jack man, when we have those right side adjustments, I definitely got to make sure that tire doesn't get away because it's hard to come back from a lap down. Mm-hmm. And it just makes things harder. But like he said, man, we attacked it and we take it on now mm-hmm. versus putting our heads down and yep. do the best we can with it.
Yep.
See, we have a lot of new athletes watching our show and crew call. As you know, I'm involved in NASCAR Diversity Drive, Drive for Diversity, Pit Crew Development. Mm-hmm. So I'm around a lot of athletes who don't know the sport. So when you have guys like you on the show, they're looking and they're listening. Mm-hmm. And for what they're talking about with these adjustments, when you have 5 crew members making adjustments and you have to do them in the amount of time that they have to do them, it slows the stop down. Would mm-hmm. you say a second?
Well, yeah, it's like one of our stops, we had, I think, you know, we were like a 12-6 on lugs, mm-hmm. but we had a left side side double adjustment, 2 rounds, and put tape on. So normally with a 6-man stop, we would have mm-hmm. been fine. We could have dropped the car normal, but Darrell's going to the adjustment wrench. I'm going to the grill to put the tape mm-hmm. on. So Tingler, our front changer, when he's done, he's got to go drop the jack. And so, I mean, that adds time right there.
Coach, I'll tell you what, when I was pitting cars, that was one thing that was really challenging, you know, is when you go to the race and a crew chief will say, hey, we're going to be adjusting on his car all day, right?
Yeah.
I mean, what goes through your mind when you hear that? It's got to be.
Yeah, well, you think about all the variables that come with it. Like, you know, what if you're racing against teams that aren't doing adjustments?
Exactly.
You know, nobody, you know, there's a lot of things that are looked over, you know, with what we do on pit road. And so you just hope the guys do a solid job. You hope the adjustments go away. So when the big stops come up towards the end of the race, you know, we can do some no adjustment stops. So we got a chance to compete. But with this new style, man, if you're doing adjustment and the guys aren't doing adjustments, there's a big time advantage there for the guys mm-hmm. aren't doing any adjustments.
Exactly. So, I mean, therefore, you just got to get your car set up right.
Yeah. No
you
doubt.
Know, a lot of that falls on the crew chiefs and a lot of that falls on your driver. You know, there's some drivers out there, they can lose. You can lose positions on pit road, and that driver will make it up for you. Mm-hmm. But when you don't have those capabilities, you really just have to be on your P's and Q's. And the margin for error is very small.
No doubt.
So knowing that, it even says a lot more to what you guys are doing, because you guys, you're ranked pretty high on the board as far as all the pit crews overall. There's a system called the Infinity System that you're aware of. And with that Infinity System, it keeps track of where you guys are. And I believe, if I look it up, you guys are right about, let's see, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You're sixth on the chart, you know, on top pit crews on pit road. And that's minus the super speedways, and that's minus, crazy adjustments at the same time. But that's pretty impressive. And that says a lot for you guys at RCR and what y'all are doing
We definitely take pride in that. And Ray has done an awesome job building our pit department up from guys within. I think Ray can really pride himself on that our whole team, our three team, has been built from guys within the system, within the program.
That means a lot.
And he can go more on that, but it's a big credit to Ray for doing all that.
And I'll go more on it. Actually, Ray has changed, the culture. Mm-hmm. Big thing about the culture, man, he want positive guys around. He want guys with the mindset that they're going to keep working. Mm-hmm. And for myself, I've been around the sport 4 or 5 years, and guys that get to the top, that top house car, and they keep working. Mm-hmm. They don't settle. They
don't get complacent.
Exactly.
The hardest workers
in
the building.
We both, me and Paul, coming in together, we both pride ourselves on not stopping, not settling, and just getting better each and every day.
Yeah.
Great point. So much to talk about. We're going to go to a break real quick. I mean, we've got Ray Wright in the house. We got Paul Swan. We have Darrell Edwards. RCR is repping really hard right now. So stay tuned. Come back. We got more of these three individuals invading my studio today.
What's up? Vaughn Gittin Jr. here. How would you like the keys to a 700-horsepower, custom-built Ford Mustang RTR? Designed by none other than NASCAR champ Joey Logano, the RTR design team, and me. It's one of three Mustangs you could win in the MoneyLion Here We Roar sweepstakes. How do you enter? Just text ROAR to 95615 or visit roarsweepstakes.moneylion.com.
No purchase necessary. Instant 2019. Must be 18 or older. For official sweepstakes rules, visit roarsweepstakes.moneylion.com.
At the Goddard School, teachers customize lessons so children can explore their interests, have fun, and learn the skills they need for success in school and beyond. From infant sign language to pre-K students tackling STEAM learning, our Flex Learning Program or Fun Learning Experience is grounded in research that shows the most genuine learning occurs when children are having fun. Our teachers leverage this through lessons inspired by children's imaginations. To enroll, visit GoddardSchool.com. The Goddard School, learning for fun, learning for life.
Winged Nation with Steve Post, Aaron Evernham, and Ashley Stremme. Your destination for all things winged sprint cars. Each Saturday at 8:30 and 11:30 a.m. on MAV TV. Live at noon on WingedNation.com and Facebook Live. Join us for in-depth conversations with drivers and personalities that make up the greatest dirt racing on earth. The Winged Nation Preview Podcast each Thursday previews the upcoming weekend. Winged Nation, winged sprint car talk covering dirt tracks all across America.
We started Pit Stops Open 2013 when we found out that North Carolina has the highest percentage of child hunger in the nation. Winston-Salem, High Point, and Greensboro are horrible areas for child hunger. On top of that, our teachers, they're the lowest paid teachers in the country. So we thought with our stage of NASCAR that we could raise a bunch of money and help these people out who need the help. At the end of the day, the community is going to help the community. And if we want to see a change in our community, we got to do something about it. And that's what Pit Stops for Hope has done. Since 2013, we've donated over $100,000 to Second Harvest Food Bank. We've donated over $50,000 to Salvation Army. And we're putting on events like this to get kids ready for school. We got school supplies, so we're doing what we need to do for this community.
And there you have it. Pit Stops for Hope. Man, that's a great program you have right there going on. And MoneyLion is a sponsor of us, and they really like to focus on financial aspects to what we do on and off the track. And we have a financial crew chief. That's what we like to call that. And you are definitely personifying that. How did this come about, Ray?
Man, in 2013, truthfully, we're in a Bible study, man. And I walked out of the Bible study one day thinking, what are we doing, man? Mm-hmm. We just go in this room. We talk about, same Bible, same verses, and, we feel real Christian. But then we walk out, and we're just back to normal.
Mm-hmm.
And so, man, I Googled problems in North Carolina. And
Googled it.
Googled it. I mean, look, I lived in North Carolina for 8 years before I had a clue that we had as many food insecure children as we have in our state, you know, so my head was in the clouds too. But that was a top, that's what came back on a search. And I contacted Clyde Fitzgerald with Second Harvest Food Bank. He sent me an email back 2 hours later, and that's what got us going.
So as far as this program, what areas do you focus on?
So we started out with food insecurity. That's a big deal, right? Because we got a lot of hungry kids going to school. And if you got hungry kids going to school, they're not focused. They're not ready to learn. Their brains aren't developing. We got a lot of elementary age kids that are hungry. So there's a lot of cognitive delays in growth. So that's a big deal. You know, it's a big deal. So we're trying to get food to the kids. So doing that in the schools, we've met a lot of teachers that are providing snacks, school supplies. And the teachers are all paying this out of their pockets. Well, we got teachers aren't paid too well. So we've got teachers who don't have a good budget, who don't have the classroom they want. They're teaching kids who are hungry, who aren't really motivated. So what we're doing as a society is we're propelling this cycle of poverty in our society. And we do it every single day. And it's about time somebody brings it to the forefront and that we raise awareness so we can get these kids. Our thing is we're trying to get every kid an opportunity to succeed.
Absolutely.
And we might not be able to do it, but we can raise the awareness for bigger organizations to put more power into it.
That's great what you're doing there. And I really like just to piggyback on what you were doing with the teachers. Teachers are very important to us, and, you know, they are underappreciated. And I really appreciate what you're doing with the Teacher of Month Award. You're awarding them $500 you were giving them at a time, and they do buy their supplies on their own, and they have a lot of challenges they have to face. So that is awesome that you're doing that. I do have a question. How do you get your other crew members involved, and how do they gravitate towards what you're doing? You know, when I was working with the Petties, we had similar stuff with the Victory Junction Gang Camp and how we used to help out with them. It seems like something similar. Is that the case? Mm-hmm. And does your crew members, or y'all can answer, do your crew members, what do y'all, how do y'all feel about this?
I mean, for myself, when I came to RCR in 2014 and got pretty tight with Ray about 2015, and he told me about Pit Stops for Hope and, you know, what it does. And, you know, I've really never been a part of something like that or really had a passion for something like that. But after talking to Ray and going to some of the events and seeing some of the people we help, man, it really hit me and really touched me. And, like, man, this is really something. This is an awesome organization. The stuff we're doing for people, you can see it, like how happy they get when we go to the Salvation Army or the food bank and stuff, and you just see them, their faces light up when we give them food or, you know, a backpack or some school supplies or anything like that. And then we started doing track sales and just seeing how excited people got to buy the stuff, the old race gear, and to help the people in need. And it's just, it's an awesome thing, and it's a good thing to be a part of. Feels good, and it's fun to see what good the Pit Stops for Hope does in the community.
The track sales, Darrell, do you have any memorable stories from Pit Stops from Hope and the track sales at the racetrack?
I mean, mainly just being, like Paul said, seeing those faces light up and take pictures for the people. We let them up on our pit box, things that don't normally happen on a typical race day for a fan. We allow them to do that, you know, as well as selling the gear, old crew shirts, lug nuts. Those things go a big way for the fans and to keep them around and, you know, just bring love and support to the sport. So they really love it.
You touch on a good point there because, like I said, when I was pitting, you were around the fans and they are looking for the drivers. The drivers are pretty, their schedules at the racetrack, they're unattainable. They're focused on the race, you know, they're being mobbed. So they tend to stay out of plain sight. At the same time, the most visible guys there are the crew members. I felt like it was a responsibility for the crew members to facilitate that type of stuff for the fans, to sign the pictures, to show them the stuff. It's not just sitting out there on pit road, just staring and just, you know, now an hour before the race, we're getting game mode. When those headphones come on, don't talk to me.
Right.
Because I hate everybody at the track. But at the same time, you know, I feel like that is a responsibility of pit crew members to do that. And y'all exemplify that very, very well. And, I appreciate that.
Appreciate
it. Hey, we have these three guys, the best that ever did it, the best out there, the best coach and crew members in NASCAR in my studio, and they represent Richard Childress Racing, and we'll be right back with more from these three unique individuals.
Here's your chance to win a set of your very own Hercules tires. Go to HerculesTires.com/MRN. Simply register, and each month we'll give away one set of tires. Hercules Tires has the value, selection, and industry-leading mileage coverage to get you wherever you need to go, no matter where the road takes you. Register now for your chance to win a set of Hercules Tires at HerculesTires.com/MRN. Hercules Tires, ride on our street. He is the envy of the racing world.
I assumed that Ryan, Bubba, and Chase were all busy, and I was the next in the pecking order.
She goes way back.
When did you meet?
7th grade, 6th grade?
No, 9th grade. That was a minute ago.
And he just wants to be friends.
Are we friends?
No.
It's the Sunday Money Podcast. Join Corey LaJoy, Daryl Mott, and Lauren Fox as they detail what it's like to live the racing lifestyle both on and off the track. Download and subscribe to Sunday Money on iTunes, Spotify, and your favorite podcast platform.
It's butts and nuts jammed in there.
Since 1942, Freightliner has been an industry innovator, developing trucks renowned for their dependability and efficiency. Whether your job requires a dump truck, a concrete mixer, or a delivery truck, you can count on Freightliner to maximize your productivity. With a wide range of horsepower and torque rating that meet even the most demanding job conditions, Freightliner trucks are built to build your business. Learn more at Freightliner.com. Freightliner, work smart.
All right, who's ready to learn? You know what time it is. It's time to get school. It's time to learn something, and I'm going to learn you something. I'm going to learn you something this week about the All-Star Race. Like that? I'm going to learn you something. Like that. That's what my grandma used to say.
No more teaching. We're learning now.
Well, I'm going to learn you something today.
I'm going to learn today.
You got to be from Atlanta to understand that. But anyways, hey, we got the All-Star Race this weekend. I want to teach everybody on the format of All-Star Race. First of all, the All-Star Races are... You know, you have the NBA, you have the NFL, you have your things. All-Star Race is a little bit different. We try to make it exciting. We throw $1 million to the winner, which that's all I really need.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
You know, but at the same time, you know, one thing I really looked forward to in All-Star Race was just my shoes. And what gear I was going to have,
right?
I got something for him.
We're big on the gear. We always got to make sure we got the...
Gold boys.
Bringing them out. It's RCR 50th, so we got the gold incorporated and everything. That makes it fun for us.
Let's go through this format of the All-Star Race and explain these stages. The race will have four stages with a five-lap increase in the final stage compared to last year's race. The stages will last 30 laps, 20 laps, 20 laps and 15 laps. I think it was 10 laps before at the end, so that's another 5 laps at the end. Both green flag and yellow flag laps will count in stages 1 and 3, with only green flag laps counting in the final stage. NASCAR overtime rules will be in effect for stages 1 through 3. In the final stage, if the race is restarted with 2 or less laps remaining, there will be unlimited attempts at the green, white, checkered finish. So that means we're going to be there all night. Or until there's 2 cars left.
Right. We'll keep racking each other to win that million.
Because when you're racing for $1 million, it's going to, man. Anyways, for the 2019 edition, all race cars will feature 2 key technical elements that NASCAR may incorporate into the Gen 7 car slated to debut in 2021. So, in a nutshell, guys, All-Star Race, are you excited or what?
I'm excited, man. It's a different way of pit stops, coming off the wall once the car stops.
Oh, you're talking about qualifying?
Yeah.
I'm talking about it all.
How could I forget qualifying?
You got to bring that up, man.
Who cares about the $1 million?
You want to see the race crews, baby.
What makes the All-Star so unique for all my new NASCAR fans is the fact that qualifying is
it involves a pit stop.
Yeah. Explain it, Ray.
So you got they're gonna do a lap on the track, then they come down pit road, no speed limit, like old school Dale Earnhardt flying down the freaking pit road. And I mean, those drivers got to get into that box, man, just like they would, you know, for a regular pit stop. So the guys, it's a little different because guys can't come off the wall until the car is stopped. Because that's probably the safety thing that they throw out there.
But I don't like that.
No,
I know.
Let us jump. Just maybe give us a box or two leeway. Yeah. You know, give not just the
it's
one.
Like
box.
You're standing on the wall, holding your water, watching this thing screen down.
Exactly.
And more than likely, I mean, how is Austin coming in the pits? Is he gonna blow through his box?
Man, he did great.
He did an awesome job last year. So.
He finished 12th in the All-Star race. I remember. Was that his first one?
Mm-hmm.
That was his first race. Finished 12th. So I don't know. He might be in contention. I haven't looked at your odds yet.
Yeah.
Well, what are y'all doing to practice? How are y'all practicing and preparing for this? Because after the All-Star race, you have the 600 and then Pocono. Yeah. So, I mean, how much focus do you dedicate to the All-Star race as a pair? Or do you?
I'll say one thing, then Darrell can answer. But it's a pit stop that is competitive, right? So mm-hmm. we want to be the best. So we're going to throw a little bit of work into it. Mm-hmm. And the guys have been all about it.
Yeah. Oh, so y'all are doing a little trick play.
I mean,
I don't know, you have to wait and see.
Yeah, I wouldn't call it a trick play.
Not
but
give me anything right now, pal.
We're wearing our eyes on what we want to do, how we want to do it.
Has it been done before?
Yes.
No, oh, Dad?
Yeah.
With give 5 minutes? Anything, man.
I got to
been done before.
Oh, that's.
It ain't been done like how it's going to be done by us.
Ooh.
But nah, man, like Ray said, we've had some focus on it this week for mm-hmm. sure. But just weighing our options, making sure, just being clean, man. I think like every other weekend and week out.
I'm reading the context clues. The way Ray flipped that to you, I feel like you're going to be shouldering a lot of the responsibility on this this choreography.
I mean, that's every week. I'm the jack man, right? I'm the quarterback.
So how you sleeping at night?
I sleep well every night. Yeah, got to, man. Sleep well, man.
I wanted to talk about you guys as far as how y'all came to RCR. How you got to mm-hmm. RCR. And if my memory serves me right, you guys have won on every single level, and you two in particular, together.
Yep.
You came in together, you won together.
Yep.
And Ray, I mean, not only were you a standout athlete at LSU, which I found out, you know, which I should have known, but you were a tire carrier.
Yeah.
Balling, beast mode tire carrier.
During your time, man.
I know.
We're getting it done out there.
Hey, there's the boys.
There it is. Look at the boys on there. Oh, yeah. And keep in mind, all of our footage and all our videos, you can view all our film on MRN.com or the Motor Racing Network Facebook fan page. But other than that, you can listen to it.
That was
well,
a good time right there, baby.
See that picture? Is that a butt cheek up there?
That's a butt cheek. That's a booty
cheek. Winners.
So, yeah, they win Daytona 500 and they get tattoos on their butt tucks.
That's right.
That's interesting.
It's the spot to get them on. Some people are into arm sleeves. Some people like the shoulders.
Hey, we're getting away from topic. Didn't I ask y'all a question?
Yeah.
All right. So, yeah.
So we came into the sport. Obviously, graduated college from High Point University in 2014, around May. RCR. I did an internship, actually.
At RCR?
Yeah, at RCR before I graduated. It was about a month or two long. Just putting in hard work without getting paid. So I would finish class on a regular day, go up to RCR and just hang out, work, clean up, glue up tires.
Who made you do
tires.
That? Your daddy made you do
nah,
that?
Nobody, man.
Just grab you by your ear and make you do that?
That's something you're born with, man. Okay. That's like the mindset of trying to make it out of where you come from kind of deal. So I just put my head down and got to work, and those guys gave me the opportunity. They said, hey, man, we're willing to give you a job. You go take a week home after you graduate. We'll give you a job if you want to come back and try this thing out, man. So that's how it went for me. And then Paul came in a few months after me.
Yeah, I came in. I went to Bowling Green when I was done playing in 13. 14 came around, and I had to do an internship to graduate. So I talked to Coach Clausen right when I found out he got the Wake job and said, hey, you know, I'm cool if I come down with you guys and Coach Horgan.
Go Deeks!
That's right. BG first, but we'll take Deke second. Yeah. Don't worry. And then so I came down with all my coaches down to Wake, did an internship in the weight room, and my plan was to just be a strength coach after I was done doing that internship, just stay on with them. But found NASCAR, one of the strength coaches who had been there for 10 years already, you know, mentioned to me, hey, have you ever heard of NASCAR pit crews? Actually talked to Kevin Harris, who's on the 20 pit crew. He was on the 88 at the time.
Another Demon Deacon.
Yep.
Another one of my sons.
He came and visited, and I talked to him about it, and you know, he told me all about it. And man, I'm like, man, this sounds like a really cool opportunity. Mm-hmm. And so I did some tryouts at some places, RCR, Roush, and stuck on at RCR. Really liked the people there, and just like Darrell, kind of had to work my way up. Wasn't getting paid.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of driving around doing low level races, and we worked our way up to where we are now.
Ray, how'd you end up there?
Man, I was at Forsyth Country Day School coaching baseball when young Austin and Ty Dillon were going to high school there.
Really?
And I was also training the boys over there. And it was right at the time where RCR made a change with their pit crew trainer. So then I came over to RCR as training the pit crews.
Mm-hmm.
And then just started carrying tires. And
very good at carrying tires as well, I might have to say. You were doing it.
Ray was a very solid rear tire carrier.
Yes, he was. Yes, he was. Guys, that's a great story. And at the same time, it tells you when you're a team like you are, I like to say, alone on an island. You're out there. That camaraderie, that family aspect of it, I feel like is so important, you know, because I've been there. I know how important that is, you know. And then so it's great to see. Yeah. And it's great to see y'all represented the way you do on the track. Hey, we're not done with these guys yet. My other favorite section is coming up.
Oh,
the
yeah.
Clutch Performer Award is coming up. So stay tuned. We have a big list for you. And then we got a little highlight reel for you as well that you might enjoy. Thanks to the captain. The captain will be blessing us. Stay tuned. Come back.
Who's Rocko?
Rocko, my boy, you know? You know Rocko?
Did you know that banks collected over $15 billion in unnecessary bank fees last year? Come on, enough is enough. It's time we took back control of our finances. That's why MoneyLion is proud to bring you the Financial Crew Chief and to be a NASCAR sponsor. Look, no one knows more about hard work and pursuing their dreams than NASCAR fans, drivers, and teams. So we want to bring you the kind of banking that the big banks would never build, with features like zero-fee checking and zero-fee investment accounts. And because life is also meant for a join, with MoneyLion, NASCAR fans get even more. We're giving away 1,500 NASCAR tickets to our members this year. Plus, you can get 5% cash back on NASCAR tickets, at track purchases, and all purchases at NASCAR.com. Learn more at MoneyLion.com or download our app. This is America's most powerful financial membership. MoneyLion, here we roar.
Clutch Coffee Bar in Mooresville, North Carolina is redefining the drive-through coffee game in Race City, USA. The Clutch experience is fast, friendly, and delicious. Quality drinks and unmatched customer service is the name of the game. Clutch Coffee Bar offers signature lattes and mochas, custom flavor-infused energy drinks, smoothies, and more. Over 25 flavors, there's something for everyone. Visit our two locations in Mooresville, 356 Williamson Road and 154 West Plaza Drive. Open daily from 5 a.m. to 9 p.m. Power up today with Clutch Coffee Bar.
Yep, yep, come on, I'm back, we're back, we're lit, we're turned, excited. Any more words? No, whatever.
Get your tickets, baby.
Get your tickets, baby, to the what show? Yeah, whatever.
We are the show, baby.
The gun show right there, baby. Well.
Hey, let me try it.
Well.
That's pretty good. That's not bad.
How about that picture?
Love it.
You know what I would say, when you get a tattoo, if I would have got a tattoo on my buttocks, I would put some color in it. You know, this honey brown skin would look really.
He's got some color on his.
Oh,
you
easy.
Got color on your tattoo?
Maybe.
So you have it. So Ray, maybe. Is your tattoo on your buttocks?
I don't have a tattoo on my.
You didn't do it.
Nah, man.
Anyways, all right. Enough of that. Clutch Performer of the Week. You know, when you give me a lot of time to look at pit stops, you'll have a list that you're about to see. Now, today we are highlighting. All of the Jackman and tire carriers from Kansas that performed exceptionally, or just performed. They were on TV because they were running well and they were up front. Yeah. And when you're running well and up front, you're on that spotlight.
No doubt.
So therefore, you know, whether your car is handling well, whether your driver is doing well, or whatever the case may be, when you're on TV, the eye in the sky does not lie.
No doubt.
So you can hide on your performance when you're running in the back, but you can't hide when you're in your car.
It's the truest statement ever. The eye in the sky does not lie.
It does not lie. So we're going to turn this eye on right now, create a little highlight film for our Clutch Performers of the Week, and enjoy. And enjoy the music by our very own The Captain.
Get out my way, yo, they gon' watch you disintegrate. I'm nice with a pick gun, them lugs, I hit them straight. Don't believe me, get a pass and watch me demonstrate. Some of y'all think you fast, but you finish late. And war, clean the grill, prepare the dinner plate. Look like some pit road kill, we having steaks. The crowd ain't clapping for them, they playing patty cake. Going hard all year, man, I need a break. And throw a dirty mo party right by the lake. Ain't nothing like a NASCAR mosh pit. We taking off, cause the captain in the cockpit.
Yeah. I like that.
Get out my way. Like look at that long list for your reading enjoyment right there. Can we go down it real quick? Paul Swan, Darrell Edwards, Brad Robinson, Justin Edgell, David O'Dell, Eric Grone, TJ Ford, Shane Wilson, Phil Foster, Sean Cotton, Dwayne Moore, James Hawk. Hope I said that right. Will Goodnow and Joe
Hoke.
Crossin.
Big Hoke. Big Hoke. Hoke.
Double pump shouldn't slow a pit stop, though, man.
You don't think so?
No, I'm totally joking.
I was about to say.
Yeah, I'm about to say. Yeah.
You see?
We've heard.
We're giving you the pick your mindset.
Hey, you see, when we watched that film, I was the one dancing because I've seen it all, but they were Hawkeye-ing it. They're watching it. I mean, the eye in the sky doesn't light, guys. Nope. What'd you see there? You know, you saw different ways of tire carrier dropping a tire off. You saw changes bringing it out. What are your thoughts,
I mean,
guys?
So I think the way we've done it, we timed it and kind of experimented with it. I think me handing the tire off, we feel is the fastest way of doing it.
Because it's based off of personnel,
yeah,
right?
That's what we always say. Every pit crew is based off of personnel. Mm-hmm. Can your personnel handle certain situations? What can they do? Where are they faster? And I think our right fronts become so much faster when I hand it off.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like myself, I'm fast enough to get back there still and hang the tire fast enough.
And it also depends how you hang. Whether mm-hmm. you step, you are a stepper, and whether you swing. You know, it all depends.
Coach, why did you teach Darrell to double pump the right side?
Yeah, that's what I was looking at. I was looking at the pitability of the cars and who was doing adjustments and who wasn't doing adjustments.
Yeah. We laid it down, every time.
Yeah.
So. Y'all were making adjustments every stop, like you said, you know. And so anyways, guys, you know, with that being said, we have the All-Star race this weekend. Good luck with that. You have the Coca-Cola 600 after that, you know.
The marathon.
It's a long one.
That endurance race, and then we have Pocono. So, I mean, y'all have your hands full, man, and I'm sure you have a lot on your plate. I wish you guys all the best, you know, up in the season because you are the best.
We appreciate you having us.
Those position records awesome. Change. I can appreciate that, man.
You know? That's dope, man.
That sizzle.
RCR in the house.
That's what we should have put up there. Let that sizzle now. Yeah, we appreciate you, Rocko. Yeah, thanks for having us, man.
Anyways. That's us, MRN Crew Call, presented by MoneyLion. RCR is in the house. They have taken over my studio. We appreciate y'all coming down. See you next week. Taking over my studio. You can say whatever you want to say real quick. 30 seconds.